exams coming closer and closer and closer. Some of you may be getting very tensed up. Some of you may be saying, it's okay, yaar, I'll deal with it. But in either case, you'll be having a lot of people who'll be telling you, study hard, study hard, study more. Actually, I don't believe in that, you know. I don't think studying hard gets you results. I think studying smart gets you results. What do you mean by this thing called study smart? It means being able to know when to study. There are times when you need to study, there are times when you don't need to study. It means to know where to study. Oh my God, it makes so much difference where and how you're studying, you know that. And then comes the techniques. How to study. There are different ways of studying. What suits you should be the one that you should pick up. Once you do that, then you become selective. What to study, when. After you have mastered this, or while you are mastering it, there will be one question that you need to ask yourself, that is, why to study? Why study at all? Is it just to get that stupid extra marks? No, it's much more than that. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take you through this process of when to study, where to study, how to study, what to study, and why to study. If you understand these concepts, believe me, you'll not only do much better in your exams, you'll have true learning taking place. What goes in will remain permanently with you. Okay? Best of luck. Now you're going to sit down and study. You made up your mind, exams are coming close, and now I'm going to put in the best of my efforts. The question that arises is, what should I study? I've got this stupid, horrible subject which I hate. Compared to that, I've got this subject which I like, not very bad. I'd rather read this. No, don't do that. Take the difficult subject first. Your mind won't be on it. You won't be feeling like studying. Tell yourself, first 15 minutes, that's all. 15 minutes, if I study this, I'm going to reward myself by spending the next hour studying my interesting subject. 15 minutes if you can sustain on this, when your mind is fresh, something goes into your mind. Stop, because it's a difficult subject, it's a boring subject. If you extend for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, nothing will go in your head. So you've done that, 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, whatever you can, stop at that point, put it away. Spend the rest of your time reading something interesting. But before you get up, again go back 5 minutes, 10 minutes, revise this. So in the beginning you had this difficult stuff, in the end you had this difficult stuff. In between, if you feel like it, jot down what you need to study, particularly these difficult guys. Hey, that fourth chapter has not gone into my head at all. Make a note of it. That tomorrow when I'm fresh and up to it, I'll start with that fourth chapter of this subject so that it goes into my mind. There's another thing about, what to study and how. If you're the type of person who takes a book and starts reading like this, you know, one line at a time, you'll find that your progress is very slow and you'll find that at the end of it, you hardly learn anything. Try and learn how to read chunks of material, look at a paragraph and see if you can take in that entire paragraph by just browsing at it. It's difficult at first, it doesn't come so easily, but you practice and over a period of time you see how you are moving from one chunk of matter to another, from one paragraph to another. You will now start going faster and faster. When you get stuck, when you realize, hey, this paragraph didn't make sense to me, stop, go back to it. Spend more time studying that. But the moment you realize that this is easy and it's gone into my head, move on. Don't waste too much time reading it line by line or something of that sort. And this brings me to a very important point. Unless you understand the basic fundas of what you are studying. Don't move on. If you say, it's okay, I've mugged up a few things, the important things, it doesn't matter, let me move on to the next chapter. You know what happens? In the next chapter, things get even more difficult. In the third chapter, it becomes so difficult that you don't even understand head or tail of what's happening. So make up your mind and say, I'm going to get this cleared. If I can't understand it, I'll go to a friend, I'll go to a classmate, I'll go to my parent, I'll go to my teacher, I'll talk to somebody, I'll Google it if nothing else. But I will find out and I will make sure that the basic fundamentals are clear in my mind. Another thing that we forget to do sometimes is, I have read up these three chapters, I'm comfortable with it, I think I know everything. So I don't want to keep going back to those three chapters. I will go on to the fourth chapter and I'll start reading from there. Don't do that. Have you seen these TV serials, what do they do? When they are starting with a new episode, they give a recap of the previous episode. Do a recap. What was there in that third chapter which I read? When you look at it visually, you will catch on. Everything comes flooding back into your mind and then move on to the next thing. There are a few things about what to study which I want you to keep in mind. Don't skip from subject to subject too far ahead. Don't take up too many subjects in one day. It's a holiday or it's a preparatory time, etc. You have the whole day to yourself. You're going to be studying for many, many hours. Try as far as possible not to spread yourself too thin. And this is very important in languages. You may be studying two languages, for example. If one language you have studied today, study this other language tomorrow. Don't study two languages on the same day because the grammar is different, the sentence formation is different, so many things are different. So, one of some of these small things, when you are studying an important subject, go on to the lighter subject, go on to the lightest subjects, come back and revise this subject. Take a big break if you want. Take a nap in the afternoon or go out and play for an hour. Your mind is, then you have that clean slate, then you can start the whole process all over there.